It's happening.
I'll be honest, I'm not a big fan of Power Rangers. I'll admit, I did grow up with Power Rangers as a kid, and it was definitely one of the best shows I saw as a kid, but I stopped being a fan because I slowly began to loathe Power Rangers, and not because of its cringing quality. When I was in elementary, kids would always make fun of me for liking Godzilla. They would always criticize the tokusatsu effects, yet, ironically, these same kids praised Power Rangers for the same damn thing they criticized the Godzilla series for. So I began distancing myself from Power Rangers because I thought, at that time, that the franchise only attracted posers. As I got older, I discovered that the Power Rangers franchise was actually an American adaptation of a Japanese franchise called Super Sentai. Whenever I discuss Power Rangers with someone, I would always say that I'm a bigger fan of the Japanese series than the American series. And why? Well, because Super Sentai is so much better. With the exception of a few, a majority of the Power Ranger shows are exclusively made for children. Now, don't get me wrong, Super Sentai is technically a children's franchise as well, but they're catered towards a family audience rather than just for kids only. That's why I love the Super Sentai franchise better. Even an adult can enjoy it on a fun, campy level. I tried to get back into Mighty Morphin Power Rangers recently to prepare for the new movie, and I just couldn't get into it. Every episode made me cringe. So instead, I tried to get into the more recent Power Ranger shows like Samurai and Megaforce. Again, I just couldn't get into them for the same reasons I couldn't get into Mighty Morphin. The original Mighty Morphin Power Rangers is an example of something from your childhood you remember was awesome, but when you revisit it as an adult, you realize that it wasn't so great as you remember. The original Power Rangers has aged badly. Under the direction of Disney, the Power Rangers franchise has at least tried to progress and even mature a little bit. The best example of this is Power Rangers RPM. However, ever since Saban reacquired the franchise, they've set the franchise way back. Once again, Power Rangers is a franchise that appeals to children only instead of a family audience like Super Sentai. So when the first trailer for the new Power Rangers movie hit, I was probably the only one that gave it the benefit of a doubt. While everyone was criticizing the movie already for looking like a fusion of Chronicle and The Breakfast Club, I was one of the few that was actually praising it for that very reason. For the longest time, I've always believed that the Power Rangers franchise desperately needed to be reinvigorated, and the first trailer for this movie showed some potential to be that reinvention. So was 2017's Power Rangers the reinvention I hoped it would be? Was it better than the original show? Did it exceed my expectations? Short answer, yes to all three questions. I saw this film twice on its opening weekend, and I can genuinely say that I definitely loved this movie. To be honest, I didn't expect to love it as much as I thought I would. While I was definitely impressed by the first trailer, I wasn't 100% excited for this movie. I was achingly curious, but not hyped. I was actually expecting the movie to be bad because it was produced by Saban, and they haven't really been too keen on progressing or maturing the franchise, but they've proven me wrong with this film. Like I said before, I've always believed the Power Rangers franchise desperately needed a reinvention, an absolute breath of fresh air, and this film is that very reinvention I was hoping for. Even if you are not a Power Rangers fan, you have heard of the classic phrase "teenagers with attitude" that is heavily associated with the franchise. This film definitely lives up to that phrase because the movie features complex characters with sophisticated issues that work surprisingly well. For the last few years, studios have tried to add a level of realism and relatability to tentpole films like The Amazing Spider-Man, Fantastic Four, Chronicle, Man of Steel, and so on. It's an element that's either a hit or a miss. In the case of Power Rangers, it's a definite hit because I personally found myself empathizing with all of the Rangers, and that's what made the characterization for these new Rangers great. We managed to get attached to these characters that by the time they morph into the Power Rangers, the payoff feels satisfying. Zordon was another character that surprised me. In the original show, Zordon was just a dull, lifeless character whose only purpose was to give exposition in every episode. However, this iteration of Zordon has a level of humility and humanity to him. I thought it was great how Zordon was handled, and once again, the great Bryan Cranston delivers another fine performance, even if we only see a CG version of his face. Rita Repulsa was another character that surprised me a little bit. Although she lacks a level of humility and humanity like Zordon, this version of Rita was too damn fun. Rita was very charismatic and just chewed every scene she was in. You can thank Elizabeth Banks for that because she clearly had so much fun with that character and we the audience have so much fun watching her. Goldar, however, was a major disappointment. In both the original Jew Ranger series and original Mighty Morphin series, there was a great level of characterization to Goldar. And here, he's just a big gun. They could have easily created a different random monster and it wouldn't have made a difference. I'm also not a fan of the design. It forsakes the classic design, which was unique and original, and replaces it with an inferior design which feels lazy and uninspired. Fortunately, what wasn't lazy and uninspired was the story. The original Power Ranger series were mostly plot-driven, but the movie settles for a character-driven narrative, which is where the heart and soul of the movie lies, within the characters. I guess that's why I love this film, because every Super Sentai show after Jetman became character-driven shows. In fact, the movie feels more closer in spirit to Super Sentai than Power Rangers. It was serious when it needed it to be, and it was silly when it needed it to be, just like Super Sentai. However, some critics felt that the tone was all over the place. I completely disagree on that because I felt that the film had a balanced tone, and I feel like that criticism is a bit hypocritical, and here's why. The movie is clearly heavily inspired by The Breakfast Club. However, The Breakfast Club has a similar tone like Power Rangers. In one scene, things get serious and then the next scene, the tone shifts to something lighthearted. For example, the tone of the infamous Eat My Shorts scenes where Vernon gives Bender a month's worth of detention is dead serious. There's little to no humor in that scene. However, in the following scene, the tone suddenly shifts to a lighthearted tone where the gang leaves the library to fetch weed from Bender's locker. The Breakfast Club is filled with shifting tones such as this, yet The Breakfast Club is praised as a masterpiece by critics. Power Rangers also has a similar shifting tone, yet critics call it a mess. Maybe I'm being a little biased here because I love the movie, and maybe the shifting tones is a mess? But personally, I found that the tone was balanced. Like I said, it was serious when it needed it to be, and it was silly when it needed it to be. Overall, I was very satisfied with Saban's reboot of Power Rangers, despite that I'm a bigger fan of Super Sentai than Power Rangers. The movie had great, well-developed, complex characters, a lot of heart and soul, and a surprising good use of pop culture songs. Hardcore fans of the original Power Rangers might be put off by this mature, nitty-gritty, relatable reimagining of Power Rangers, but like I said before, this was the reinvention the Power Rangers franchise desperately needed. It's a shame that the film underperformed at the box office because there's a story and characters worth exploring more in sequels. If planned sequels are cancelled, I can at least take comfort in knowing that Saban at least produced one great hell of a Power Rangers movie. I award Saban's Power Rangers 3 stars out of 4.